regardless, she's the same skater we've come to know and love. Action getting started down here. First bout, we'll get to the Gotham roster after this first one. Bam, who do we have down on the line?
Right now, of course, that would be Bonnie Thunders, number 340 in the black, trying to take that inside line. She got pushed down with a nice strong defense from Barbara Ambush. She's going to get back at the pack. We can't. Wow. The action, very intense.
Indeed. Olivia shooting John right there. Almost snuck out on the inside, and there she does it out of turn two. Some great defense from Gotham, but a nice start for Texas, picking up the first lead jammer.
As we can see, Bonnie Thunders in a position she's not very commonly found, which is not lead jammer, but, of course, very closely behind. Coming back into the pack, Olivia shooting John gets up and, oh, gets a bit of potentially a late hit. But remember, contact is still legal, just like points, until the fourth whistle. She came in. Short jammer, again, already in that much more of a short crouch. Very easy to get that kind of a bump.
That's right. And again, a good, quick, early start here for Texas. Gotham has been, they have been down in the past in the early jams, but they're that team that seems to like one or two jams just to get things shaken off, kind of feel out their opponent, and then they strike.
As you can see in the position, that is Susie Hot Rod in the black, trying to make a shuffle along the outside, pushing up through, not quite through yet, the wall of white for Texas.
Tough two all up front for Susie Hot Rod. Hold her back long enough, and again, Texas back-to-back leads to open things up right here. And that is number 108, Fifi Nomenon. Came out last year, saw a lot of good stuff from her at Champs, and we expect to see more out of her, heavy in the rotation here jamming today, Bam.
Absolutely. We have right now Susie Hot Rod about half a track behind. As you can see on your screen, nice bit of a spin move there. See how many points she was able to pick up. It looks like two on that pass. Gotham held to zero. Though not an uncommon thing, in all honesty. You will see another team come out, strike first blood, get a little bit of a gain on Gotham, and then Gotham slowly starts to creep up. Sure, the Texas fans at home right now would be like, Texas. But again, Texas, not to be outdone, is not afraid to go for the throat from the gate and get those points and then hold on to that lead. And you can see that's what they're trying to attempt right now, though only 2 points in two jams.
That's right, 2-0 lead right now. Looking at Bonnie Thunders versus Killbox out there for their respective teams. Bonnie Thunders in the black for Gotham, dodging a hit right there. Nice move around out front and picks up lead jammer. Meanwhile, Sarah Heupel stuck up, tough wall in the back.
Indeed, as your screen is indicating right now, you have the wall at the front. You've got Sweet Sherry Pie, who is in at the front, waiting for that interior line. Getting the push still. Sarah Heupel not able to get around. She's got two, if not three. OMG was mixing it up. Sarah Heupel gets knocked to the inside, has to reposition herself. Nice move defensively on the part of Gotham to make her work for it. Bonnie Thunders, though, continuing to struggle. Gets pushed up, almost goes sideways, trying to get through the pack. One, two, three, fourth is trying to get into position, not making an easy pass for her.
Absolutely, that was a nice hit back there from number 86, that's Akilla Salmonella. Meanwhile, nice move by Smarty Pants, forcing Bonnie out, dropping all the way to the back and making her reset. Meanwhile, out front, Sarah Heupel pushing hard, but Gotham's wall so tough, Bam.
As we see, Bonnie Thunders just almost able to get out, but no, nice. Bit of a nudge, again, blocker goes down. She's able to get through pass. She's not gonna get that quickly through, but she gets 5 points on that pass, and she's about to point. Again, if she can get through, we've got Sarah Heupel getting knocked to that inside. That is Benita Applebaum once again in Sarah Heupel's way, not giving her an easy time at the start of this game.
And right there you saw at the end of that jam, some great work up front. Bonnie Thunders, of course, phenomenal jammer. Everybody knows that. But the thing that you got to look at with Gotham is how well their pack works. Out there, OMG playing some solid defense. Saw her jammer coming, switched over, opened up a little bit of a hole for her, and got her out. All right, so after three now, Gotham striking 9 points in that last jam for Bonnie Thunders. Texas still sitting at 2 7-point game, and we are lined up for jam four.
We have got Olivia Shooting John in the white going up against the aforementioned Vicious Van Gogh, who right now has the 1-2-3 wall. If you get past, she's got plenty of scrimmage practice with them. Let's see what's going to happen on the track right now. Gotham not able to assist. They're leaving Vicious Van Gogh to her own defense. She gets pushed out, waiting to see. And outside of the zone of engagement, have to let her go. That is Olivia Shooting John as your lead jammer, though Vicious Van Gogh has broken through and is now playing catch-up.
That's right, short pack right here, real quick for Texas. Already had Killa Salmonella in the box. She's now released They've got one in there. Right there, quick strike. Handful of points, four up on the board for Texas before Gotham could get back in.
And that's how quickly it can change. You know, you've got those slow gains. All it takes is that one breakthrough. Olivia Schutenjohn tries to turn the tables. Vicious Van Gogh not able to catch up in time to get into position. It looks like you've got Susie Hot Rod on the line for Gotham. Fifi Nominon, I believe, is going to be skating right now in the jammer position for Texas.
Fifi Nominon, second jam for her. You picked up lead in the second jam of this bout and opened up scoring with 2 points to get Texas on the board right there. Nice move, goes to the outside, but sneaking through on the inside, Susie Hot Rod.
Yep, everybody was paying attention to the Texas jammer, and Susie's like, I'll just go this way if you don't mind. She's trying to decide which way she's going to go now. As she gets somewhere to the pack, gets the three wall, decides to slow down, does not want to draw the foul, but we do have jammer going to the box right now, Texas, so we have a power jam happening for Gotham.
That's right, major track cut right there on Fifi Nominon, an early chance for Gotham to really get a run going. This is where the Gotham girls shine. They get the power jam and they really know how to capitalize. Right there you see the passive offense to kind of hang back, let Susie Hot Rod fight through, and she picks up a grand slam on that pass.
Pack doing a nice job of waiting, just trying to hold position there. Susie Hot Rod is able to get through, not much contact even made as she breezes past, picking up another 5 points. You can see on your screen she's coming back around. Nice side view shot. Texas really trying to position. Gotham has this brilliant strategy. They can just trust their jammers to get through, as happens again and again, making Texas really have to shuffle, putting them in that defensive position.
That's right, another 5 point scoring pass right there for Susie Hot Rod. And again, this is exactly what I was talking about. They're so good at taking advantage of the power jams. You know, even strength, these two teams have been slugging it out back and forth. Gotham a little bit of advantage, but if you give them the opportunity, they will try and run away with it. Fifi Nominon out of the box now. Power jam is over, but still a 4-on-3 in the pack in favor of Gotham.
Well, and again, that strategy we talked about works so well for Gotham because they're just waiting at the back, and they are just waiting in front of, unfortunately for Texas's jammer, where they're going to be coming back into play. So she's got a whole struggle to get through, and it looks like just she comes in and she cuts the track.
Oh, tough break here early for Texas and Gotham. Big run, Bonnie Thunders with another grand slam right there. And that is huge to open things up in this game. Early on, looking at penalties, Texas already getting into a little bit of trouble. Fifi Nominon again, second time in the box as the jammer in that jam. They've already got 5 minutes up on the board. As far as penalties go, and only one penalty so far for Mick Swagger of Gotham.
You know, this might be a non-surprise for some folks, but we do have Bonnie Thunders on the line for Gotham. Whistle's underway. And we see it again. Gotham, they can trust Bonnie Thunders to do what she does, and that is get through the pack. She's able to do it legally. She becomes your lead jammer. Nice bit of a move at the last moment. Shortcut almost able to hold her off for about 3 or 4 seconds, but decides to let her go. Does not want to draw the foul, especially being down the jammer right now.
Absolutely. You don't want to lose any of your blockers to the box when you're in a penalty kill against Gotham. Right there, great effort by Shortcut, but Bonnie Thunders so quick. Watch her lateral movements as she's going through the pack. She's got power, she's got a strong core. So she gets her shoulders in there, works them, and she's also, watch her feet. See how she cuts back and forth right now, pushing against that wall. She's got such a good base, she can take those hits, keep pushing up, and then just cut when she needs to. Right there, beautiful pass by Bonnie Thunders. That is textbook bad.
Well, and when you consider it's really putting Texas in a defensive posture of having to match her ability to shift position very quickly. Smarty Pants, number 5 for Texas, was doing a great job on the last 2 passes in particular. We saw Loose Bandit follow out a little bit, but again, she pulls herself back. As we see now, the jammer is out. Fifi Nominon, but she has got that 4-wall to get past of Gotham. And she's got Vicious Van Gogh on the outside, and she cannot get the edge.
That's right, tough to get around her, especially when you've got Donna Matrix anchoring that wall out there as well with hyperlinks and anabolics.
Bonnie Thunders once again decides to hold up. She comes into action, almost gets around, then the pivot decides she can get one little piece of her, slows her up. Bonnie Thunders now in the middle, but she has gotten through the pack. Fifi Nominon now, she has got the pass initially done. Does not get time to get back around to score, however. So that is going to make a bigger gap now. Texas at 6 points, Gotham at 58.
That's right. Like we said, you know, as we talked about at the beginning of this broadcast, man, Texas striking first, Gotham kind of hanging back, letting them kind of play their game a little bit, and they've reacted. In the first four jams, it was 11-6, and now 58-6. 47-point run for Gotham here in this last handful of jams.
Benefit for Texas is, of course, their jammer was released from the penalty box on that pass, so now out there is Olivia Shooting John. She is caught at the back. Gets a rather large bump happening from Mick Swagger, who's not afraid to make contact. We do have the jammer out. That is lead jammer for Gotham.
Claire D. Wade, nice job picking up lead jammer. She's got about a third of the track right there. Look at her hopping around. Gets slowed up, calls it off a little wildly, and gets tattooed right there in the sternum. Sent down, beautiful hit right at the call-off.
We'd love
nice
to,
work.
Yeah, we'd love to get your opinion on this game as well. Find us at hashtag talk2WFTDA. This is one of those classic matchups. We have no doubt you have an opinion at home if you are watching, so please, hashtag talk2WFTDA.
That's right, the number two, as in two teams out there, Gotham 61, Texas 6. And these two teams fielding some of their superstar jammers. Bonnie Thunders out there with the black for Gotham, working her way up front. Meanwhile, Sarah Heupel being forced to the inside right there, having to reset, and lead jammer goes to Bonnie.
And as you said, Sarah Heupel is now once again behind that two-wall, trying to get a nice bit of a bridge, as we do have some folks in the penalty box. I believe that is Mr. Sven Gogo, who is about to stand. But Bonnie Thunders is able to get around, picks it up very clearly. A 5 points. Sarah Heupel has that last defender. She is able to get past. Looks like it was just at the edge of 20 feet anyway, but she does make the legal pass. She's able to stay in bounds as Bonnie Thunders, just at the outset, gets the call from the bench to end it before. And it looks like, indeed, Texas was not able to pick up any points on that.
Nice job. Heads up right there, looking for her bench. I mean, she's got such great awareness out there on her own. But when you've got, you know, legendary coaches out there who can tell you when to call it, she heard the cue and robotically called it right there before she got in.
Well,
nice job.
That's, again, that training that we talk about. You know, that's one of the people often ask, what does Gotham do? What's their secret? And it's they train. They work. And that's one of the reasons that we're seeing Texas here. They absolutely work every bit as hard. And it's the dedication of the sport that we're seeing play out in such an amazing game right now with number 55, Susie Hot Rod, trying to get that last edge around the defenders, trying to stretch it out to 20 feet.
Nice effort out front by number 22, Polly Gahn for Texas. Slows her up, but Susie Hot Rod out on the straightaway between turns 2 and 3. Meanwhile, Texas Jammer having a lot of difficulty out there. Some great effort by OMG riding her out. Oh, she goes out of play. And that's going to be a finished initial pass and one, as Gotham's going to lose one to the box.
Indeed, that's number 55 for Texas, Haas the Boss. She's not new to the team, but we have not seen her jam a whole lot in this level of competition. As you saw right there, though, Perseverance gets past OMG. OMG just stretched it out a little bit too far on that.
That's right, and it's nice for Texas now looking not to have OMG out there. You know, there's so the roster's so deep. Just looking at Gotham, there's players who have been around for a long time who have really put in the work. Some of them unsung, people like Hyperlinx, who's a fantastic pivot. You know, you've got Donna Matrix out there, but OMG has come to this team from Montreal,
yes,
and really made an impact out there blocking.
Absolutely. She's one of the key players I know in their off-track experience as well. Vicious Van Gogh out in front. She is your lead jammer for Gotham. She's got a clear track as they have to reposition. Getting a nice bit of a recycle at the back for Fifi Nominon, who's almost passed there. Bit of a hard, two hard contacts in a row. And that is, it looks like, Vicious Van Gogh being sent out to the penalty box for Gotham. Also the contact with Desecration, number 222, being sent to the penalty box.
Oh, and Fifi Nominon now going to the box as well. Major back block, so we're going to have a jammer switch out right here. As soon as Fifi sits, that will release the jammer. Fifi Nominon, Vicious Van Gogh now released.
But again, that was about 5 seconds to sit, so Fifi Nominon is back out on the track as of this moment. It's a moment to catch their breath, but it doesn't look like it's going to be helping a whole lot, as Vicious Van Gogh still has one defender. I believe that is Loose Bandit.
Indeed it is.
Number 33. She is through, but as you see, Jammer is right behind her now, drafting, as it were. Interesting to see number 404 for Gotham. Hyperlinx all of a sudden just gets in the mode and skating right with him. Doesn't realize the pack is well behind her.
5 points on that pass for Van Gogh and 4 points for Fifi Nominon. Just Van Gogh picking up the extra box point when Fifi was sitting in the sin bin. right now. Fifi Namanam pushing it up front. Great job breaking through that wall. Picks up 4 points for Texas. Meanwhile, a little bit tougher for Vicious. Takes a hip whip to finally get out. Picks up 4 points to match as well.
It looks like Anabolics was sent to the penalty box for a multiplayer block, if I saw that signal correctly. Either way, though, she is still there sitting. Definitely a heavy-hitting game.
Absolutely. These two teams, very technical usually. But you know there's a lot of emotion, again, in this rivalry. So it gets a little scrappy, Bam.
Absolutely. And when you consider the history and the story of these two teams, I mean, when you think about it, these are teams that are often mentioned when roller derby comes to mind. So we have a timeout that is being brought to you by the Texas bench.
That's right, 4-4 in that last scoring pass. So a nice even-up jam between those two competitors right there. You see Fifi Namanon in the white for Texas. She's looking a little winded. She's had a rough go early in this bout, already with 3 trips to the box, 2 cuts in that same fifth jam, and then in this last one picked up the major back block. You know, looking at the rest of the penalties down the board, 2 for Molotov, M. Pale for Texas, Desecration with 1, Killisell Manila picked 1 up back in jam 3. On the other side of things, Gotham, a lot of penalties in that last jam. Donna Matrix picking up a clockwise block. This is Van Gogh with the back block and Anabolics with the aforementioned multiplayer. 3 penalties in 1 jam, and that matches their total for the rest of the early part of this bout. So indeed, 6 for them.
Indeed, we talked again about the jamming prowess of Gotham in particular. When you look at the penalties, you've got, unfortunately for Gotham, you have Vicious Van Gogh, who's already accrued 2 trips to the penalty box. Other than that, no penalties from the jammer position. You've already got 3, and we've got a lot of time left to go in this game.
Absolutely, with 14:26 left in this bout, we are coming out of the first timeout called in this game. It was attributed to Texas, so they have 2 remaining right now. The score 85-18 in favor of Gotham, and away we go. Who do we have jamming, Bam?
That is going to be number 340, Bonnie Thunder. She is up against number 03, that is Olivia Shooting-John in the white for Texas. Gets pushed out on the outside, Mick Schwager. Goes all the way back. The follow through, that actually was OMG who makes that initial contact. Very smart move. That was the contact of Mick Schwager. The OMG again backing all the way up, just making sure she has got to work it. Bonnie Thunders already has 1 pass under her belt. Now trying to work on 2. If she can get past that wall of white.
Great job by Texas right there. The trick with Bonnie Thunders is stay together right there. She finds a tiny bit of room, sneaks out, and she is finishing her scoring pass. Meanwhile, Texas Jammer did get out, but already 4 up on the board for Gotham. They're going to call that one off before Texas can get back around. No chance for Shooting-John to pick up any points. It's going to make it 90-18 with 13:30 left in this first half. Now, Bam, looking at the jammer rotations, as we were talking about, you know, Fifi already in a little bit of penalty trouble, Vicious Van Gogh the same. You know, looking down the board, you've got Bonnie, Susie, Vicious Van Gogh. That's basically been it for Gotham. We have not seen a lot of Susie either. It's been very Bonnie heavy. On the other side of things, Livia Shooting-John, Sarah Heupel, Fifi Namanon have really been the anchors of that.
And they're trying to see if they can make another one with number 55, Haas the Boss, in jamming for Texas. She's got a 2-all to get around, but is stretching it out. They do have to let her go. Texas picks up lead jammer status, number 55. Though we look on the other side of things, cleared away in the black, jamming her second appearance with the jam star. Nice bit of a hop at the last minute, getting around the 2 defense of Texas. She is through. Haas the Boss already in scoring potential.
Oh, Haas the Boss taken down right there. Great block with the booty by Susie Hot Rod. She goes down, and Haas the Boss picks up a major low block. Legs a little sprawly right there, took down a Gotham defender, and we've got another power jam for Gotham, but oh wait.
Wait a second.
Spoke too soon.
No, we don't. Track cut. What was interesting, cleared away's penalty happened well after Haas the Boss. It was just Haas was on the other side of the track. So technically, they're both going to sit at the
almost same time.
Same time, but remember, the penalty starts when you get to the track. So the advantage goes to Gotham. She was just closer to the penalty box.
Absolutely. So quick release right there for Vicious Van Gogh and Haas the Boss out as well. Even strength in the pack. 4-on-4. Sorry, cleared away the jammer for Gotham right now. The 4th jammer's in this one. Yeah. That was the thing we talked about, the heavy jammer rotation.
They put her in every once in a while.
Exactly.
Like, Claire, go stretch your legs.
Well, Claire and Haas have been the 4th jammer, essentially, in these rotations early
Absolutely,
on.
Absolutely correct. And we see there's an effective nature right now. Strong defense happening, and it's a great capture on your screen. You've got the little wall of white, seeing if Claire can get past it, but it is broken apart there due to a penalty. Texas skater goes to the penalty box. Going to make an easier opportunity for a five-point pass right there for cleared away. Unfortunately, from the Texas side, Hostabaugh had a lot stronger defense to get past and is not having much luck whatsoever. Though nice bump. Loose bandit gets the push. Great move back right there from Barbara Ambush. Really making cleared away. Have to earn her position back on the track.
That's right. After that one, we are sitting at 95-21. Texas coming back a little bit. Correction, 98 score update right there for Gotham. We've got just under 11 minutes left. Looking at this next one, it's going to be a 4-on-2 in favor of Gotham. Two in the box right now for Texas. Sarah Heupel sitting down along with... Who is that with her? Oh, that would be...
I know, Ringster is so great. But yes, we rely it on it. It's right there in front of us. As we get that information, Olivia Shooten-John gets pushed out at the last moment. She is jamming, but the jammer star. Also, the finger being pointed at that is going to be Bonnie Thunder. She is your lead jammer. As you see on your screen right there, once again, Olivia Shooten-John is getting pushed out by Mick Swagger. They are just sicking her on her today. No love lost between the two of them on this track. Bonnie Thunders gets an easy go around one more time for another 5 points. They get over the century mark there. Now 103, Texas 21.
Great defense in the pack right now. Mick Swagger anchoring things. Nice rapid fire hitting. You know, she almost got out of there, but Swagger just threw that shoulder back in. Nice rapid fire hitting from 503. Meanwhile, as Bonnie Thunders goes around for a grand slam pass, pack getting a little thin out there, Bam.
It happens.
Indeed it does.
In this type of game especially, we talked about the hard hitting that's going on, and they are very vigilant. This is a great ref crew, as they all are in general, but particularly at ECDX. Some big names from the ref side of things. Really calling a solid game. And it is showing as the penalties are slowly accruing, but they are definitely having a factor, particularly to the benefit of Gotham.
Absolutely. 4-3 right now, this time in favor of Texas. So the OMG sitting in the box for Gotham.
As we get our position, Vicious Van Gogh in the black, jamming. Inside line, gets a quick move, about three steps. She is out. She is your lead jammer. Her competition right now, in particular, from the jammer side of things, is number five, that is Smarty Pants, who's also got some good speed, but she has got to do some catching up. They're going to see if they can hold her down. Vicious Van Gogh is able to get through. She gets her hands on her hips, but I believe there might have been at least one pass. No. She was able to get there in time to call it, so Smarty Pants does not cross that to get that point.
That's right. Smarty Pants, first time jamming. She, good two-way player, does a lot of blocking. And again, she comes from a little bit of a different background. For those of you that don't know, she started on the bank track in Austin before moving over to flat track just a couple of years ago. So she's got a little bit of a different skill set that translated very well. She does not jam a lot because she's so smart, and that's her name is for a reason. She is just brilliant out there defensively. All right, back to the action. 116-21 right here. We see Susie Hot Rod dodging hits left and right, picking up lead jammer for Gotham.
55-55, Susie Hot Rod in the black. Hostabaugh getting caught right there at that corner number three. They have to let her go. Fisty Cuff says, you know what? All right, that's fine. I got Susie Hot Rod coming up behind me. Susie Hot Rod gets a bump down to the floor, decides to call the jam, only picks up 4 points on that pass. Therefore, Gotham now at 120, Texas 21. We have got 7 minutes and 50 seconds left to play in our first half.
Now, a 99-point lead here. This has kind of been the story for Gotham. You know, not only over the last couple of years, but this season they have come out very strongly in their early games. They beat Philly 260-94, beat Minnesota by 230 points, and then Windy City by about 273. So we expect to see these kind of big gaps, but never count Texas out, ever. They're a scrappy team. All they got to do is change one thing up, keep a little cleaner out there, and we could see them chipping away.
Absolutely, and you're going to see dedication happening right there from number 03, Olivia Shooten-John. We want to make sure that we mention that she, in my opinion, is one of the most perseverant jammers I have ever seen. I've watched her skate for years, and you can just throw her at the floor, throw her at the wall. She will get back up. She will get back out there. Unfortunately, though, she is being sent to the penalty box.
That's right, cutting the track, major penalty right there. Power jam now for Bonnie Thunders, and this is where Texas does not want to be. Down a blocker, they're going to get her back. But still, already a grand slam goes up, and she's got at least 50 seconds left on this power jam to capitalize.
Gotham just steps aside. Oh, though we do have a little bit of assistance trying to form the wedge. That is Hyperlinks trying to pry it up for the inside. Bonnie Thunders just waits, doors open, she's able to take that. Texas tries to reposition on that line. You see one, two, three, four Nice bit of a move. Barbara Ambush has her eyes in the right direction. Nice bit of a shuffle. OMG tries to break it up. Is able just to move the position but not open any doors. Bonnie Thunders does it herself.
Yeah, that's right. All you got to do is get your foot in the door, and that's what OMG did out there. She got them to shift just a little bit. If you open up just that little bit of a difference between shoulders and hips, all you need is this much space if you're Bonnie Thunders, and she just makes it work.
Especially, she's one of those skaters who definitely knows how to use her momentum to her advantage. It's the rarest of occasions you'll see her draw a backlock. She really knows how to shift, how to maneuver. As you saw right there, she with all that full force going to the outside, stops, brings it across to the inside. Olivia Schutenjohn, also very agile skater, as we see right there. She's able to move position, hold it along that inside line, gets out. She's got hyperlinks. Sweet Cherry Pie to get past, gets a move around, and they got to let her go 20 feet.
That's right. Great teamwork out there with those two. You know, one takes the lead, the other one gets a little bit behind, and they just recycle up. Great movement out there. Gotham Pack, so good at working together.
It looks like we have got a official review, which is brought to you by Wicked Skatewear. Sarah Heipel runs out, puts her hands on the shoulder, so we might be getting a review out of this. But again, we want to thank Wicked Skatewear for helping us out and being our partner for all of our official timeouts. I'm sure that everybody loves the official timeouts, and I know that Wicked Skatewear certainly does. Want to also say hello to Dragon Lady, who's very pleased by the footage happening, brought to you by Blaze Streaming Media here on WFTDA.tv. Thank you so much, everybody who is watching at home, in the airport, wherever you need to be. Mobile platforms aplenty. Sponsored by WFTDA.tv.
That's right. So with just over 5 minutes left, right there we see the Gotham bench. Mrs. Van Gogh, just focus. Look at her face right there. She's so focused.
It's like she's a little sad.
Nah, I think she's pretty happy right now. Yeah, she's probably, you know, well,
but I mean,
think of
the emotion.
Conflict.
That's what I'm
yeah.
saying. That's if you look at that, yeah, you're definitely in a position. You've got 148 Gotham. You've got 21 for Texas. But she's going up against what she, I often understand, considers obviously her home. She's Texas born and bred, loved being a part of Texas, has moved on to Gotham for various reasons. But now, at a point where she's being so utilized to beat her other team, definitely got to be emotions on that face right there.
Absolutely. She does a good job masking it. Speaking of masking their emotions, our referees right now. Out there discussing whatever Sarah Heipel brought out there. It looked like it might be a penalty discussion. It does not seem to be points related. The score again, 148-21, 5:23 left in the first half of gameplay here from ECDX 2013 on WFTDA.tv. We've already seen some great action here today. Got to see the Wall Street Traders, the B team out of Gotham, take on the Philly B team. On this track, a little bit of juniors action after that. And we had Mass Maelstrom versus the Shock Exchange. So a whole lot of Gotham here early in ECDX. And looking forward through the rest of the weekend, Gotham is going to be taking on Atlanta tomorrow at 4:30 p.m. Going to be a fantastic bout. Atlanta, an upcoming team, they really made a name for themselves last year, not only as great hosts of the WFTDA Championships, but also coming in strong and showing that they're not to be trifled with. They're an up-and-coming team. Right there we see Singer talking to Sarah Heipel about a cutting penalty.
Having that conversation. Hopefully we will get the specifics of that when it comes back up here.
And score update, if you did miss it, I mentioned the Shock Exchange versus Mass Maelstrom. Shock Exchange won a nail-biter, 170-158 over Mass Maelstrom.
Especially interesting is right before this game started, I took a look back, much bigger score differential before. So that was a nice rally at the end there. We get back on our line. Everything is decided. Again, when we get that information as to the specifics, we will bring them to you here on WFTDA.tv. But in the meantime, number 5, Smarty Pants for Texas. Gets pushed to the outside, has to regroup herself. Number 55 up at the front with a three wall in black. That is Susie Hot Rod.
Indeed, right there, taken down. Tough shoulder hit sends Bonnie to the ground. She's going to draw a major penalty, though, so Texas is going to lose one of their blockers. Looks like Sarah Heipel going to take a seat with a bad girl sit. Meanwhile, Susie Hot Rod pushing her way through, picking up a lead jammer for Gotham.
As we see, number 5, Smarty Pants, once again, gets pushed to the inside, has to get herself legally to re-enter. Now she's got OMG to get around. Nice blocking happening once again at the front. Big bruising hit coming right there from Mick Swagger. one of the most solid blockers. And what I like about her is she doesn't make a big swing. It's a quick impact, but it's a devastating impact when she does.
Absolutely. We already saw her rapid fire ability out there. She's just so solid, but she can move the top part of her body and just get those shoulder hits in. Right here we see Susie Hot Rod coming back around. Easy pass right there. Nice job by the superstar.
And you were speaking of shoulder hits, and I think that's the thing Susie Hot Rod does really well. She comes in, she does not lead with the hands. She very often knows she throws the chest forward, those shoulders down, and she can make that legal bump contact very well, very effectively. Even if she can't push someone out of her way, she stops her own momentum to reposition. We don't see a lot of those hands coming up. So she's doing a good job of that so far. She gets another 5 points on that pass.
Gotham Mechanical right now. A couple easy passes out here for Susie Hot Rod. Big contact right there in the pack. And Texas Jammer sneaks through. Nice job. They just kind of threw a curveball at Gotham right there.
And Smarty Pants has had a number of times where she's almost able to get through, but she got pushed out. She had to come back to re-enter from the back of the pack to keep it legal, especially when you're considering Gotham 168 Texas. Not any movement in the last several jams as they still sit at 21 points. You can't afford to make any mistakes right now if you're Texas. And they made a couple early, and that's what the penalty board is showing us.
Absolutely. Looking at the penalties, you've got 8, 10, 12 on the side of Texas. And Gotham, a little bit more penalty heavy than usual, but still sitting only at 8 majors in this first half of gameplay with just over 3 minutes left in this first half, 168-21. And we've got Bonnie Thunders out there up against number 30 for Texas. That is Bloody Mary.
First time we've seen her jam so far, but someone who is not new to that jammer position. Like we said, they've been having a bigger rotation on the side of Texas. They're going to throw one more in right now as she's trying to get past that wall. Beautiful defense at the back for Gotham. Texas is not quite able to hold Bonnie Thunders, though they did get her for a good long pause, definitely able to slow her down for 30 seconds.
Tough defense up front right now. Gotham, they're getting a little bit too far out. Out of play goes up, and they let her through. So initial pass done for Texas, but Bonnie Thunders strikes quickly, picks up 4 points, and calls it off. Now you're talking about Susie Hot Rod, the way she uses her shoulders, her upper body. Bonnie Thunders, same thing. Even though they have a slightly different build, they're so good at just getting those shoulders in there, working them back and forth until they can get a wedge and then just slip through.
Well, and a lot of that is you'll also see, if you can watch closely, they tuck their arms. They very much, and I know that we were talking earlier about the men's teams, and that was one of the criticisms that I heard is that they start to throw those arms out, and you can see that that's a thing that has been really solved on the part of Gotham, at least. Texas also trying to pull. You got to tuck those in.
That's right. 172-21 right now in favor of Gotham, and Gotham Girls picking up another lead jammer right there.
And that is Vicious Van Gogh. She is front. She is now going to be coming into contact with Barbara Ambush, trying to move along that inside line. She's able to keep on her skates, getting a little bit of a nudge from Desecration, but does get past, picks up points, and calls it.
Yeah, just before Hasselbos gets back around, she made it into the pack, but it was all white jersey, so no points for her on that one.
That is the strategy that Gotham has used in the past, and they're using it today. Get out, get points, end it.
Yeah, and you know what, Bam? Looking at this right here, the thing that really stands out for me with Gotham, no slam to Phage right now. No Sexy Slady in this bout. Two very strong blockers, and given they're so deep, but Slam to Phage was such an instrumental part, especially at Brouhaha, of augmenting that jammer rotation. It seems like Vicious has kind of taken her spot as more of a speed jammer, whereas Slam to is a very powerful, push-through power jammer.
Yep, and the strategy is working in both considerations for Gotham, particularly today. We have cleared away once again, jamming for Gotham on that outside, trying to make a run.
Oh, shrugs off two huge hits right there. Picks up lead jammer for Gotham.
That was Hasselbos and, I believe, Polygon. Though it might have, if the action happened so quickly.
Great movement right there from Donna Matrix. Sends Olivia Shoot-John into the infield all the way back into the straightaway between 2 and 3. Meanwhile, Pack all gummed up into turn 4. Claire DeWay gets knocked all the way into the infield. She's going to reset back in turn 3, and it's just a traffic jam out there, Bam.
As you see, they have that whole position cleared away, paying attention as she realizes jammer is through Olivia Shoot-John, but it is concluded right there. Olivia Shoot-John had maybe about 10, 15 seconds before she was going to get back around to engage. They realize we are already over into what could be our halftime. All we have to do, and the jam, and indeed, we are at halftime.
My name is Brenda Gold, and I've been at Rydell for 36 years almost. Everything is done by hand, basically. Just one pair actually going through at a time then. And some of them are multiple colors where it'll have 5-6 colors, metallics, the different colored full grains, you name it. Some of them are pretty wild. To me, the skaters are really important because that's what keeps us going here. It's the consumer or the skater that decides, okay, is it good enough for me or not? We want them to be happy, that's for sure.
Susie Hot Rod from the Gotham Girls Roller Derby in New York City. And you're watching WFTDA.tv. Is that the right address? All right, yeah. Woo! Technology.
We are going to see as we line it up. They were waiting for the countdown. And then they all made that smile, as you saw right there, because we have to wait for that whistle right there to get our jammers underway. That is Sarah Heupel in the white for Texas. And 340, that happens to be Bonnie Thunders for Gotham. Both taking a moment to see which way she is going to go. Looks like we have got Sarah Heupel with that classic just push right up the middle. Texas not afraid to really make those count. And I think that's an offensive difference that we see again. Texas has push, 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 and they're able to make that play. Bonnie Thunders taking a little bit more time, a little bit more strategic in her defense. As we see, playing out right there, Sarah Heupel with the push. She is your lead jammer.
That's right. Great job pushing, as we've talked about throughout the spot, and anytime you watch Gotham, Bonnie and Susie, so good with their upper body and pushing through. It's a little bit different when Texas is pushing. Sarah left to her own devices right there, plows through, picks up four. It's a little bit more aggressive. She's getting down and dirty in there, whereas, like you said, Gotham jammers are a little bit more reserved in their push.
They are in that pass. We had OMG WTF go to the penalty box for a multiplayer block, so it's going to make it a little bit light on the side of Gotham. Something Texas, I'm sure, is looking forward to as they have right now 25 points. Gotham is at 179.
Again, 4-3 pack advantage right now for Texas in the white, taking that back wall off the start. Susie Hot Rod right now, and she's up against Olivia Shute-John.
Susie Hot Rod sees that line to the inside. Oh, I wonder if Smarty Pants left it open just to Connor in. Pushes her back. Susie Hot Rod has to put herself all the way to the back now. Make a pass through one more time. Olivia Shute-John, she's able to go out front. She is through, getting past Anabolics to become your lead jammer.
Good start here in the second half. Heupel and now Olivia Shute-John picking up some lead jammers. Again, Texas started out strong in the first half. Couldn't keep that momentum going. We'll see if they can do that here in the second.
Especially look at the speed, as we saw right there on your screen. Both of them suddenly just a flat-out race. And that's one of those situations where everybody's trying to break away and get in front of the jammers, trying to regain any kind of position. And you'll see that happen one, two times where they just all out go. And nobody has anything to do from a strong defensive block because they can't link up because everybody's moving so quickly. It's just a runaway at that point.
Absolutely. It's timeout right now on the floor. Official timeout brought to you by Wicked Skatewear. The official timeout sponsor of ECDX 2013. And I'm looking down to our right. They got a great booth over there. Lots of fantastic apparel for all your derby needs. If you're coming out to ECDX, make sure you stop by Wicked Skatewear, say hi to B-Train, and pick up some snazzy duds, or you can check them out online.
Indeed, we have a quick conference happening out there. You see our referees together. The beautifully facially coiffed umpire strikes back. He's from Minnesota. You have to wear that beard with pride. You yourself, a facial-haired gentleman.
Indeed, yes. And I've noticed most of our announcers here are really rocking the beard. You were kicking it. You brought it down a little bit. I'm glad you did. Your hipsterness was coming out too much, but you're too pretty to get that beard growing too thick. The Freddie Mercury look really suits you, bud.
Well, you know, you got to have standards. And it's not me. I don't have to hold on to them. That's why you got to have them. All right, we get back to our action. 340, Bonnie Thunders once again. Oh, nice bit of a hustle.
Wow.
That is Hosta Boss laying on the sauce. She is through front. She is your lead jammer. Pack holding nicely. Bonnie Thunders once again. Oh, but she gets a bit of a push. Looks like Barbara Ambush held on to Luce Bennett, fell to the inside. Makes it that much easier for Bonnie Thunders to get around. A little bit of an effort, and indeed she does get through the pack. But right there, Haas de Vos is through, decides to call it. Interesting, though, I'm going to ask you from your perspective. Bonnie Thunders, she's known to get through packs. Do you call it to stop her, or do you say, look, I had success as Haas de Vos getting through. I'm going to try it again.
You know what? If you're Texas right here, you want to take any advantage you can. Nickel and dime a little bit. If she gets back around, Bonnie already cut down so much of that track space. Even though Haas was coming into turn two, Bonnie in no time could have been through that pack. Given Texas had a little bit of advantage right there, but Gotham's pack had reformed.
I think that's great. As we see on our screen, that is Sarah Heupel, number 989 in the white. Jamming for Texas on the outside of the pack is Vicious Van Gogh in black, almost able to get through. The jammer makes a bit of a nudge right there and indeed gets through the pack past Polygon on that inside lane. Sarah Heupel still trying to make a move in that same direction, but she has got Anabolics holding her back at the moment.
That's right, finally breaks through out of there. Good fight again by Heupel. She's really getting that, she gets amped up, you know. Not to say that she wasn't in the first half, but you can tell she's going to that next level right now. She's channeling that aggression, and she's really getting physical out there on the floor.
As you see on your screen right there, Vicious Van Gogh having a discussion about points, thinking what she may have gotten. Again, it's all what the referee's fingers do indicate, and that is Gotham right now 182. Texas 30 points. We have 25-50 still to go. We're going to get back underway. Love from our position, we see that is number 55, Susie Hot Rod in the black, and Olivia Shootin' John, number 3 in white, jamming for Texas.
Tough wall right there, grinded down Olivia Shootin' John. Meanwhile, see Susie Hot Rod speed through, and some nice offensive pack work here in the second half from Texas. You know, they're really getting in there and they're chipping things up. Gotham has been a very solid all about, but we're seeing a little bit more of it from Texas here.
And you saw that nice four wall happening right there. Susie Hot Rod held up where she actually has to get to a point. She realizes jammer's coming back around. You got to call that. You can't start to lose any ground. Now you've got a lot of time left. Texas really has to play some catch up here, but Gotham is not a team to ever take that lightly. I've never seen them once rest on their laurels.
Absolutely. They could be up by 300 points. They still bring it 100% all the time. You know, still, we're seeing the jammer rotation. Susie Hot Rod, Bonnie Thunders, a little bit of Vicious Van Gogh, and a little bit of Claire DeWay. We have not seen her yet in the second half, but expect to see her at least once or twice.
We have Bonnie Thunders on the line. Past now, trying to move around that outside edge. Haas de Vos trying to follow suit, decides to take that interior position. Fifi Namanon, we haven't seen her jam as much. Remember, she has had three trips to the penalty box as a jammer earlier. Definitely now playing in the pack position, trying to open up that inside lane, not quite able to do it, but she does get in front of Bonnie Thunder, slow her down. We talked about tornadic rotation. Texas, they know twisters. They're trying to pick up on it right now.
Indeed they do, and speed now to the front right there. Haas de Vos picking up another lead jam, and that's the thing. They're good movement in the pack right there, and Haas de Vos, I think Texas kind of playing their hot hand right here. You know, a little bit of trouble with Fifi Namanon in the first half. Haas de Vos, a little hit and miss in the first half, but she coming on in the second half. That's two jams in a row. Very strong for number 55.
And we see the Anabolics, I believe, 0-0. That is correct. She is at the penalty box, and you saw that frustration on her face. She got the call yelling that, you know, that classic, come on! but she indeed is going to have to serve her time, and that can be indicative of perhaps Gotham. They have that consistency. They have that build, and they come back from the half, and all of a sudden, they don't have the movement than Texas is.
That's right. All right, we've got a timeout on the floor right now. And again, as you said, looking at penalties, we've got two in the box for Gotham. Again, uncharacteristic. Mick Swagger and Hyperlinx both sitting in the sin bin right now, so it'll be another good opportunity for Texas here with a 4-on-2. They've done well. Not the huge runs that we see out of Gotham, but they've done well to strike when they've had that advantage. If they can put a big run together, I think that could really spark this Texecutioner team, Bam.
I think that you are absolutely right. Something else that just seems right. CruiseSkateShop.com.
Oh, so right.
Offering quality-tested derby gear and guidance since 2007. That is CruiseSkateShop.com. I want to thank them for their support here on WFTDA.TV. Day one, ECDX. Seventh year we've done this?
Yeah, 7 years running right now. And day one, like you said, we've got so much coming up over the weekend. Oh. Again, looking ahead, Gotham tomorrow, 4:30, playing Atlanta. Got a shout-out to the Atlanta Roller Girls from the Atlanta Derby Brats, talking to us at Talk to the number 2 WFTDA. Thanks to them for giving a shout-out to Atlanta. It'll be very interesting. First ever time that these two teams have met tomorrow at 4:30, and I'm excited to say that I will be donning the stripes for that one. So pray for me.
We always do. Interesting, as you saw right there, very, very light pack for Gotham. They skate out very quickly. That breaks the pack up. It has advantage for both teams. Texas, though, is the one to actually take usefulness of it. That is Sarah Heipel. She is as your lead jammer. Anabolics once again back to the penalty box. She got out. She gets right back in. Bonnie Thunders gets nudged to the inside. OMG trying to make some assistance and not able to get in front in time. 92 for Texas making a move. That is flash gorgeous. Mixing it up.
Pardon me, Bam.
No, please.
4-point scoring pass right there for Heipel. And again, see, this is what we talked about. They need a big jam. So far, she's got a couple good passes in there. Gotham now kind of bringing it close in. But Heipel, if she can break through and get another run going, easier said than done with OMG out in front of her. But this could really get things sparked up for Texas. And there she goes again. Another scoring pass, 5 points for Sarah Heipel.
Huge credit right there to number 19, Molotov Mpale for Texas. Comes in and just pushes that blockade out of the way. Opens it wide on the inside for Sarah Heipel to take advantage of.
Big takedown right there. Nice job. Texas defenders, and then a huge retaliation hit from Mick Swagger.
That was number 19. We're just talking about Molotov Mpale.
Yeah, they're going at it a little bit. Some chin music between Molotov Mpale and Mick Swagger.
And the rally is really getting to the crowd. It is getting very loud in here right now.
And Bam, this is something you have, I guarantee you, if you've seen it maybe once, and it was probably a fever dream, as Sarah Heipel gets in there and scores again. This crowd going wild. Texas gets things going. Bonnie Thunders held back. Star passed to Mick Swagger. Bonnie Thunders got stopped to the point where she had to give up the jammer spot.
Write the date down. You're going to want to tell your grandkids. That does not happen very often, and it does not really play out the way that Gotham was hoping to. And again, an interesting switch, because Bonnie Thunders is the type you wouldn't imagine they would give her a position to be like, sure, go ahead, hand that responsibility off to someone else. And Texas, seeing that, picks up on it, really able to make that blockade.
Yeah, she got blown up by Molotov and Pale in that one, and I think that jammed her up a little bit mentally. All right, 186-48 right now. Who do we have jamming?
That happens to be
like
Susie.
I have to ask.
Susie Hot Rod, she is out through as your lead jammer, though. 0-3, Olivia Shooting John trying to get through. Gets a nice bump there. Is able to stay in. That is Hella Skelter. Haven't talked about her much, but again, she is right in that pack. She's one of those players who just kind of holds that middle position. And it's not, you don't want to say that she takes up space, but she's really makes everyone go around her. She just is that solid core that lets Gotham build off of defense.
Oh! Huge jump right at the end. No points. Didn't land it. Did Olivia Shoot John almost got it on the apex jump. Meanwhile, 4 points for Gotham and Susie Hot Rod. And Texas is really, I don't know, man. They must have put some jalapenos in their water at halftime, because whoo-wee.
You got to have that conversation. Like, you know what? We face this team. We know Gotham. We know the way that this is going to go. We're just going to put it all out there. We got a great game. They're going to have a great weekend coming up. And that leads us to another Wicked Skatewear official timeout. So we had talked about at the beginning the way that the defense was really being favored on the Gotham side of things. Seems like that has changed a little bit. Perhaps they heard you out there.
I don't know. Maybe, hey, somebody on the sidelines might be listening to us on WFTDA.tv. If so, good on you for taking all avenues of input, I suppose.
Maybe they can let us know what they're thinking. Talk to WFTDA.
Yeah, exactly. If you're on the bench for either of these two teams, please tweet us in between jams when you're sitting on the bench there. All right, so looking ready to get things back going with 20 and a half left in this game, 190-50, and a little bit of a pack advantage out there for Gotham right now.
That is your lead jammer. She happens to be Vicious Van Gogh for Gotham.
And a beautiful move right there. Hustle bustle and another spinorama. She stayed inbounds in that turn and then stayed up again. Nice hit right there. Like a friggin' bullet was shortcut. Just came across.
Yep.
Nice hip check. Center down. Forced the call off. So, talked about the Talk to WFTDA, the Southern Slayer Derby Dames say they're loving the bouts tonight. I tell you what, Southern Slayer Derby Dames, we're loving it too, and we've got more coming up.
You're not wrong.
Exactly. We talked about Gotham coming up against Atlanta. After this jam, we can talk about what Texas has going on this weekend. But right now, a little bit of a small pack out there, man.
As we see, Gotham 194, Texas 50. They had a nice little bit of a run. Seeing if they can continue that with 20 minutes left to play. Bonnie Thunders, though, is saying, nope, this one's going to be mine as she becomes your lead jammer. Stumbling through the pack, though, in all honesty, that is Olivia Shooting John, and I love the fact that she gets through the pack any which way but loose. And just like that, they realize, get a couple of points and quit it. They're just going to continue to chip away in that Gotham style.
4-0 right there, and that's what you want to do if you're Gotham right now. Texas getting some momentum going. What do? You go to your big guns, you get a quick one and call it, and then you start building up again. You got to play that nickel and dime game until something goes your way, and then you can go for that knockout punch. Speaking of knockout punches, two of them on the jammer line, Sarah Heupel, 989, and Susie Hot Rod, number 55, in black for Gotham.
And like you said before, still a very thin pack right there. We have three total right there, but Texas is able to take advantage of it with only two defenders to assist. Sarah Heupel is your lead jammer, but she better look out because in hot pursuit, right there, me and my shadow. Susie Hot Rod overtakes her on the inside on the pass. Gets through Sarah Heupel with the bump. Does not call the jam, realizes she's got to make up ground that she has lost at this if she can get past Mick Swagger and Donna Matrix.
Donna Matrix, great maneuver right there. Shoulder check in. Oh, and a little bit of action after the whistle. At the whistle, we'll see if the refs call anything. They're keeping an eye on him for sure. A little smarty pants at Donna Matrix right there at the end.
Mixing it up again. It looked like it all counted, and that's the thing we want to remind you is that you've got four whistles. Play is legal until that fourth whistle. And I want to say that I completely respect all of the referees, but the one point that always sticks out is there's so many whistles going on, and you have to hear for that initial fourth whistle because somebody whistles, somebody else will come over it. So knowing when that defining moment is, I very much respect the auditory qualities of our referees.
That's right. It takes a lot of focus out there, especially in a game at this high level. Speaking of high level, look at number 55 in white. Haas the Boss is really on a roll here in the second half, Bam.
Molotov Impale has joined the fray, trying to catch up to it mostly, but she is back out on the pack. Bonnie Thunder's now through the pack. We have four strong defense. Oh, taking a different approach. Ooh. It looks like she may have come in hot, and indeed, I think she did.
Yeah, she came in a little bit hot, got got checked up a little high, but then low blocked right there. So yep. It's going to be Benita Applebaum picking up the major low block, headed to the box. She's going to join Donna Matrix. So Texas again get some breaks here in the penalty column, and they're going to have a 4-on-2 for this next jam.
We have a timeout that is brought to you by Gotham. Having a conversation out there, as you can see, Buster Cheatin talking to Fisticuffs and Mick Swagger. Having a just quick confab, as they say. Handshaking it out. There it is.
Nice timeout right here. And, you know, as I said, a lot of great games. You can't even, like, start listing them off. It would be ridiculous. But we are going to look at, we already talked about, you know, Gotham's got Atlanta coming up. That should be an extremely fast bout. You want to see speed galore. That one is going to be incredible. Now, on the other side of things, Texas coming in. They've got Philly tomorrow at 8:30. Headline bout here on track two. And Texas-Philly, last time they played each other, it was amazing bout, 187-154. Texas won over Philly last year here at ECDX. Sarah Heupel, a big linchpin of that huge comeback. And this place was rocking, man.
And the thing that we were talking a little bit about earlier is that Gotham and Philly have played recently. And what was interesting in the first half of that game, Philly has come very close to being the shortest discrepancy between points in a very long time. So we're going to see what they learn. Now, Texas playing Gotham. I'm very curious how that matchup is going to come together tomorrow. 150-point difference right now in favor of Gotham as our jammers really pushing hard. Olivia Shooting John along the inside to come out first. As your lead in particular, Susie Hot Rod still caught at the back at the outside right now. Almost able to get around, gets a nice hit off of the defender, but it slows her up. Polygon in the place to be.
Nice movement up front from Texas, and a great job by Olivia Shooting John coming up. She saw how they kind of molded into the front. They took this dynamic wall out in front, did Texas, and it opened up just a little bit of a hole for Shooting John. She right through.
Got to do that same thing. comes in very quickly, gets a bounce off of Donna Matrix, calls the jam from the floor, picks up two on that pass, got them at a zero gain.
All right, Bam, so 203-60, 16 minutes left in this bout. So the difference right now, 143. As you talked about in that last break between jams, Philly-Gotham, 146 was the difference. Okay, so right now we're looking about the same, so it should be a great bout, you know, very competitive between Philly and Texas tomorrow at 8:30.
If indeed we are using Gotham as the litmus, which many leagues in all respect do.
Indeed, well, you know, comparative opponents.
There you go, common factor on each occasion. We have Bonnie Thunders, number 340 in the black, jamming, that is, Sarah Heupel, number 989, making a nice bit of spin move around Barbara Ambush, who took a knee. Trying to make that inside lane work for her, not getting a lot of love from it, especially as OMG pops right in front of her. Bonnie Thunder's going to make a bit of a run. Barbara Ambush says, no, thank you. Fifi Namanon now making some great contact.
Oh, high block right there. Yep, great catch by the outside Packruff.
Yep.
Now, it wasn't intentional by any means. It didn't look like she just got spun around, did Barbara Ambush. But the fact of the matter is you have to be in control of your own body. So when she hit her in the head, penalties on Ambush.
And it did. It hit her in kind of that lowest rib, but that's it. It's the momentum just carried her past, and that is what we're seeing the consequence of now. Bonnie Thunders is able to shake it off and push through up into a three-wall. OMG tries to break it apart for it, taking her to the outside lane, but she gets pushed well outside, has to regroup. Oh, but it looks like that was an elbow, and that indeed is going to send Fifi Namanon to the penalty box. It's going to make it just a little easier for Bonnie Thunders to get back into play. Sarah Heupel at the back of the pack trying to get around. And a box almost able to make a struggle for it, but not. She gets in front of her just in time.
And again, like we talked about coming into the second half, watch how Gotham so quickly, if they get a little bit spread out, they come back together. They've got this kind of dynamic wall where it'll spread apart, but then it comes back together. Spreads a little bit, always seems to come back together right there. There's another 5-point scoring pass. Goes up four. Bonnie Thunders, a major track cut called on Sarah Heupel.
And that was anabolic. She was finally able to get that draw. She'd been working on it the whole jam, and she pulls it out right there. So we've got about 10 seconds left. So depending on how they want to work it out, Bonnie Thunders is going to stop it right there. So they're going to start in a power jam as they have that little bit of a gain, about 158-point difference. And we have a timeout called. That looks like that is Texas.
Indeed it is. So Texas with one timeout left. Gotham with one timeout left. Score right now, 158 points of difference in favor of Gotham with 13:38 remaining. We're going to be talking about it all weekend, so talk to us. Hashtag talk the number 2WFTDA. Thanks to Ash Hole out of Grand Raggedy and Kalamazoo. And Lady O for your love coming over on Twitter. If you've got something to say, heck, even if it's not love, if there's something you think we could do better, hashtag talk to WFTDA, and we will hashtag not pay attention to you. No, I'm just kidding.
No. So we talked a little earlier about there being two big players on the Gotham side of things that are not there. That would be Sexy Slady, Slam DeFage.
Yes.
Now, you also have to consider that Texas has lost one. Obviously, Vicious Van Gogh going to Gotham. But as we looked on this roster, not a lot of particularly new names, but we're seeing people that they have to employ and rely on that much more.
Absolutely. You know, that's a lot of familiar faces. Olivia Shute, John Chorcutt, you know, just looking down here. There's a couple new people, but they've been around for a little while, kind of pushing up into that A-team caliber. Yep. And it's going to be interesting. This is the thing with Texas every single year. They show up at ECDX. They kind of do the circuit. They have some wins. They have some losses. But they really put it together and then come in strong into the Big Five.
And I think that's just that smart category because you see, they do have those losses, but because they're such a storied team with such a strong training history and ability, they can enmesh and fool those new people. And like you say, pull up into that A-list category. And we're seeing a very nice game from some of those players up against number one team Gotham.
Indeed, two wall up front, very strong two wall, but out of play, they got to let her go. And that's going to be a lead jammer right there for Gotham.
That is Vicious Van Gogh. She was having some fun with Shortcut. She's going to maybe try it one more time, but she says, no, I'm going to take this inside lane. And he's able to get past.
Unusual movement there from Texas on that last scoring pass. I know Swagger got in there and shook things up right there. You see her going back and forth, a little bit of a wrecking ball, trying to chip away, but a great job right there by Texas to get that dynamic wall going. But again, just a little bit of room, and those Gotham jammers can sneak through.
Number 33, Luce Bennett, a bridge too far, stretches it out. And can't hold it, 20 feet, only 20 feet. 3 meters for our everywhere else in the world friends. Watching on WFTDA.TV, another pass right there. 5 more points. We do have Sarah Heupel back in, and as soon as she gets in, the door closes. Gotham pulls their act together. Nice bit of a curtain. Sarah Heupel gets knocked to the inside, has to get back in behind Violet Knockout, and is able to do so, but once again, pushing.
Vicious Van Gogh has been the recipient of some fantastic offense from her Gotham pack out there. Right there going a little bit of solo, picking up a grand slam for the ladies in black. But early scoring passes, you're seeing some nice pack work. And that's the thing to focus on in a game like this. Yeah, we're looking at the defense right there. Oh, and a great job. Beautiful hit right there by Mick Swagger, forcing the cut on Sarah Heupel, sending her to the box just by a skate wheel. But still, a great job. Good control by number 503.
Vicious Van Gogh continues to ping pong off of the blockers for Gotham. It's like they get a piece of her, and it just knocks her out of position, but doesn't really slow her down until we see that contact happening right there. And then she realizes, oh, wait, we had a power jam, but still the benefit, they're going to come back start on that power jam.
Absolutely. Big smile on her face right there. Double thumbs up for Vicious Van Gogh. I think the internal conflict right now is being overwhelmed by the fact that they are leading right now. 252 to 60 is Gotham with 11:21 left in this bout, the last bout here on Friday of ECDX 2013. Again, great bouts coming up. And you talked about our international friends. We got Old Ricky and Glasgow playing this weekend. Something to look forward to. But right now, looking forward to seeing a lead jammer possibly out of Susie Hot Rod if she can get past this three wall.
And again, trying to stretch it as far as they can. Barbara Ambush holding position, but they can only do it for so long. Number 55, Susie Hot Rod through, already back looking for points. As you see on your screen, look at those eyes. She decides which lane is she going to take. Moves it all to the inside. Barbara Ambush gets a piece. And again, there's that twister, as we like to call it.
Right there, pushes through. That whole thing was set up in the back. My jaw just dropped. Hyperlinks just plowed to the side right there and opened things up for Gotham.
Making it work a little bit harder on that pass, as they can do. They don't have the group, so they can just break it at 20 feet. But they realize Sarah Heupel was standing. So again, it's that awareness. Gotham realizing we can't do anything but wait and then draw the curtain. But Heupel makes a bit of a bounce. She's on the outside trying to get past. As we can see, it looks like two to get in front of her as they lock arms, hold her back.
That's right. She found a little bit of room on the outside, but a great effort by Donna Matrix to speed up. Got joined by one of her teammates out there, OMG, it looked like. And right now they've re-enveloped Sarah Heupel. She is having trouble getting through as 5 points goes up for Susie Hot Rod.
Slowing it down. Susie Hot Rod's got to make a move around the three. Nice bit of assistance there.
Heupel pushing her way through again, finishing up her initial pass, now eligible to score.
If you're watching on our screen, you've got definitely a close-up of the contact happening from Susie Hot Rod. Different story at the front of the pack, though, as they were trying to regroup that position, trying to build that wall, thinking she was going to be able to come through, but she gets knocked down, calls the jam.
So, Bam, one thing I really want to point out in that last jam was, like you addressed, they were playing the passive offense, was Gotham, but it wasn't just that. They were letting their jammer push up front, but they also recognized that Heupel was in the box, so they were in a perfect position for when she came out of the box, they could just bridge it, and then play. Just the wall was waiting for Texas's jammer. Mm-hmm. So it was wonderful passive offense slash predictive defense from Gotham.
I like the term predictive defense. You should write that one down.
Oh, I will.
Body
How do you spell that?
Front. Oh, man.
I spell that LJ in a column for Bonnie Thunders. Nice footwork out there from 340 for Gotham right now as we are in the last 9 minutes of this bout. Good to the last drop, though.
Nice bit of movement, 5 point for Bonnie Thunders on that pass as a lead jammer and also the one putting scores up on the board. We've got now number 55 for Texas. Haas the boss, she is through. Barbara Ambush is back in. Looks like the penalty box is empty. All skaters, please report to the track as Bonnie Thunders decides to end it right there.
That's right. But no, the box will not be empty for too long as Anabolics takes a seat for Gotham, so they will be down a blocker. You know, looking at the penalties here on Rankster, we've got two skaters right now. Pardon me, three skaters for Texas with five, with 8 minutes left to go. Barbara Ambush, Molotov, Empale, and Sarah Heupel, all with 5 minutes in the box. Fifi Namanon with four. Desecration with three. Those are the only ones that are in any kind of trouble out there. On the other side of things, OMG on the top end of Gotham's penalties with four. Only three for Anabolix and Donna Matrix as well. Vista Van Gogh with a pair, as well as Benita Applebaum, Nick Swagger, and one for Hyperlinks, and cleared away.
Fisticuffs getting the jump going on the bench. You can't quite see it, but we can certainly see it over our monitor here, trying to get that rally going for Gotham from an emotional standpoint,
exactly,
because certainly the penalties are reflecting how they've been playing so far. But as you can see, right the screen there, Gotham's attitude a little bit different than Texas, that I really respect and appreciate. Texas, there's no look in my mind of defeat on their face.
No, that's focus.
It's focus, absolute focus right there, because they know they have got 8 minutes to go and they are never going to give up, ever.
That's right, and not only in this bout, they got to look forward not only to the rest of the season, but to the rest of this weekend. With Philly coming up, they want to make every little improvement they can in the rest of this bout against a competitor like Gotham, and then transmit that into their next bout against Philly.
I think it's going to be, I mean, you hate to call one out to watch, but there's so many good games coming up, so please stick with us on WFTDA.tv, and you can see more action like that right there. Olivia Shooting John as your lead jammer. Got some good speed on her feet, trying to get back around the pack that was just running away from her, realizing we have a different position happening, same for Vicious Van Gogh, but we see right there that the jam was called. Nobody's going to make any gain on that pass.
And a great job by Olivia Shooting John right there. Came up, she kind of had to turn backwards. I think one thing that maybe Texas could look at is their communication from their back wall to their jammer in a situation like that, because she had to turn around, look back, see where the jammer was. It was a great call off, but she instead of having that energy and trying to push through that wall and getting the call from her back wall, she had to slow up.
She had to verify that information herself, and that definitely can be a momentum killer. We have there on the outside, cleared away, getting a little bit of a push past. Now looking to go around Loose Bandit, who's taking that inside lane. Jammer does get knocked down and get back up. That is Smarty Pants, number five in the white.
Yeah, hop, skipping a jump right through that inside line. All right, here we go. Tight pack. Watch how these two jammers work. Nice lateral movement. Meanwhile, you see Smarty looking for that outside line. But the Gotham jammer's getting in there, zigzagging through.
Again, the nod, kind of clarifying. Yep, I did it. What?
OMG right there talking about the dynamics of how to call it off, saying, all right, see this? You put your hands up here, and then you come down and hit twice. You don't go for the big up, down, up, down. No, you want to go up first, come down, so you get the quick call off. We call that the Detroit deep dish. That's one more thing brought to you by the great city of Detroit.
It's making a comeback, friend. Detroit is making a comeback.
Yeah, we've been saying that for a long time.
Yeah, well, you know, we all hold out hope.
It did.
Much like the front line of defense, number 19 right there, and number 22, Texas were trying to hold out on Bonnie Thunders. They did for a little while, but not long enough, and she is already through as your lead jammer, coming back around to score some points. Number 55, Hoss the Boss, trying to make a move to that inside lane, but she has got one, two, three, count them, four people in front of her, all wearing black, that have the opposite intention in mind. And all of a sudden, it's a hugathon as the scrum takes over, trying to figure out exactly who is going which way. And it looks like forward for Haas the Boss. She gets through, but that was her initial pass. So the focus now is on Bonnie Thunders. Defender goes down to the inside. Not going to be much help right there, but Polygon's able to get back up. Not quite in front. Bonnie Thunders decides to end it.
That's right. Great job by Flash Gorgeous out there, along with Polygon. They did a fantastic job of, like we said, that kind of tornado, that twister out there. They're really working around each other. You're seeing them eclipse each other, get that recycling going, get somebody in front. You know, if you can hold that jammer back, even if they start to break a little bit, if the other blocker is already getting out ahead, they've got that advantage. Given, easier said than done against somebody like Bonnie Thunders or Susie Hot Rod, who's so good laterally, but at least you have a better shot.
Very true. Vicious Van Gogh in the black, trying to make a move on that outside. She's able to bust it up. Oh, cuts across up inside lane at the apex. Gets through to become your lead jammer. The Olivia Shooting John, not to be outdone, gets around OMG. A little bit of a trail there, but she has got to let her go. Pack's going to be back up now. The focus is on Vicious Van Gogh, and we see it time and time again. Gotham, they get that initial push through, they get some points, and they call it. But they do know, like you had mentioned, very much where those other jammers are. They're very, very good pack communicators, so they can push as far as they can and call it off moments, microseconds before the other team scores.
And that, bam, exactly what you said right there. Vicious Van Gogh, you did not see her look back once. She was getting that communication, whether it was from her pineal gland or sixth sense, the gods of Derby out there in the ether, or her pack. I'm going to go with her pack just because we can prove that scientifically.
That would be an interesting study. Let's write that one up. Number 55, Susie Hot Rod, just every which way, like slaloming through the white mounds that were blockers for Texas. They definitely held her up, but not enough to allow Jammer to come through for Texas first. Marty Pants, though, is back behind. She might be able to score out some points before Susie Hot Rod does. Oh. Takes a nice skate on the outside.
Beautiful one-handed self-whip right there from Smarty Pants. I have never seen that one employed. Usually you get the two hands up there, you get a whip with one hand. She one-handed herself around the outside, picked up the points, called it up. Yeah, she got matched right there by Susie Hot Rod. Called it off before they could get back around. But a great, great play right there by Smarty Pants.
3 minutes left to play, 288 for Gotham. Texas is at 66 currently. When we look at the penalties, though, something that doesn't happen very often, you've got not too big a discrepancy penalty-wise. Gotham, a few more trips in the box than we're used to seeing.
Yeah, 20 minutes right now for Gotham with 2.5 left. And that is pretty high. You know, Anabolic's sitting on 4 right now, Donna Matrix with 3, OMG with 4 as well.
Mighty Thunder's out as your lead jammer. Interesting maneuver having at the front of the pack, just trying to keep up on their skates. As Haas the Boss really come alive the second half of this game, really making some big plays. Looks like Fisticuffs was trying to say that she cut, but the referees are indeed saying no, Haas the Boss still in legal play right there.
Violet Knockout going to the box right now for Gotham, so they're down at a 4-on-3, but still capitalizing right here, picking up a grand slam as Bonnie Thunders.
Making that move, she's got the four wall to get around. Again, nice position. Everybody is doing a great job. They have contact with the jammer, and then they're pushing off at that last moment, really doing a nice job avoiding the multiplayer block from both teams.
Look at this, a little slam dancing out there between Haas the Boss and OMG, going chest to chest like they're puffing up against each other. But, Bonnie Thunder sliding through right there. Got to mention that real quick. But OMG, such a good job of staying in front, moving laterally. You know, the jammer kind of has that advantage usually because they can come back, get a little bit of speed going, but she's so good at anticipating where Haas is going.
We'll
see
what
hitting out this side.
No, they've got about 30 seconds left in this jam. We'll have time to line them up one more go-around, but definitely Gotham in control of this, having a conversation as she has 5 points. You got to appreciate Bonnie Thunders, of course, 5 points. Comes around, has a quick conversation with the ref before she comes back up into the pack, then has to refocus as Texas suddenly pulls a nice move. And again, there comes the speed, which, think of how hard they've been hitting, think of how hard they've been moving, and all of a sudden to keep those bursts of speed coming,
yeah,
that is what we talk about, the training paying off.
We've got a timeout right now for Texas, and nice, got to give a shout out, some of the, as we said, those up-and-coming skaters, Flash Gorgeous, great defensive play right at the end there on Bonnie Thunders. She's had a couple really nice blocks up at that last line of defense, but I got to say, Bam, I really like what Texas is doing here with Haas. Fifi got into penalty trouble. They pulled her off. Haas was hit and miss, got hot a little bit. I like the fact that they're going to her a little heavier here at the end just to give her those reps. You know, Gotham is in no danger of losing this one right now. Sorry to say, Texas fans, but it's 308 to 66, and there's 45 seconds to go. It is physically impossible for them to pull this one out, but you know what they can do is use it to their advantage. You have the benchmark. Why not see what you can do against it with some of these newer players?
And especially, like you had said, Haas the Boss really stepping up in this game. As we've talked, not only has performance increased, but the durability of her, as you saw the first time, the second time she went out, a little bit more gun-shy, a little bit more timid, taking those hits bigger. Now being able to retaliate, being able to keep that bounce-back factor that much shorter to get herself back into position so she can be that much more effective. And that's why we've seen those points start to inch up from number 55 for Texas, Haas the Boss. Though she is not jamming right now, we have got cleared away, 1984 for Gotham in the black. And Olivia Shooting John, number 3, in the white for Texas.
And one of the things I got to say about this, Gotham has done a great job you know, Heupel has had a little bit of success right there, but they have done a fantastic job of really putting the lockdown on Olivia Shooting John. The safety is on, and she has not been able to go on any big runs like we know she can. What a jump right there at the end. But it looks like there's a penalty call right there.
But it's interesting as we see.
No penalty. Okay.
Time is going to run out. I can't imagine why Gotham would want to end the game with one more jam. You know, you're just going to let it wind down. Waiting for the official time to call off, though. And I think that is it right there.
And you know what? Like you said right there, you know, why would you go another jam in this one? You know, Gotham, same thing. They like to use those opportunities as well. Texas and Gotham, yep, game may be over, but you know what? They're working on things. They're working towards the future. The thing that makes me question, why go for that risky jump at the end there? A little bit of showmanship?
And I don't think so. I think that, again, they, as we talked about, they're the team that is going to continue to push. And that is why you saw she didn't land it and she cut it, because that is that training kicking in. That is that automatic assumption. They're not saying, let's see if we can squeeze one more out. It's a, I fell. I know that I don't want to give them any advantage. I don't want them to get any points. So it's an automatic understanding that that's when they're going to end that jam. And I think that's why we saw that. And then you've got 8 seconds left. They're like, oh, okay, we'll let it go to its natural conclusion.
That's right. All right, Gotham, your victors here. Score of 3-1, 3-66 over the Texecutioners, finishing up day one here at ECDX 2013. Again, Bam, your thoughts on Gotham, first of all. What can be said that hasn't already been said?
Exactly. Thank you.
Yeah. Well, first of all, great performance all the way through. Nice pack work from Gotham. I think the big story for them is how well they execute without some of their bigger players.
Yes.
No Slady,
precisely.
No Slamda. You know, they shifted their jammer rotation a lot more from Vicious Mangogo than we've seen early in this season. And it's nice to see her come up into that rotation because, like you said, she was kind of that flux player. But where is she going to end up in the long run with Gotham in 2013?
Well, and the other thing to think about is now that she is one of those players who has left Texas, seeing the change in which Texas, and they have been in a position of rebuilding, as they say, a number of times. It looks like they're back there, but they seem to have a little bit more strength, a little bit more confidence to really get themselves back into that position, back at a point where they can put on those teams. And I am very interested to see what's going to happen against Philly tomorrow.
Absolutely. 8:30 tomorrow for the Philly game, and then 4:30 Atlanta-Gotham. Very much looking forward to both of those, as well as the plethora of great bouts throughout this weekend.
And the way to wrap it up right now, we're going to send it down trackside with Electra Blue and El Tupe.
And a good evening from Philadelphia. This is El Tupe alongside of Electra Blue. We're at the end of the first day of the East Coast Derby Extravaganza, presented to you by the Philly Roller Girls. It has been an excellent day so far. It has been a full house. The fans have been vocal. They have been enjoying themselves, and they have just seen what I guess most people would say has been a roller derby masterclass by both Gotham Girls and by Texas. Not really the bout some of us were expecting. Do you have any thoughts on this one, Electra?
Well, unfortunately, I thought there was going to be a bigger score from Texas this time with Gotham missing Sexy Slady and Paige, and gaining, of course, Vicious Mangogo, who used to be on Texas, and Fifi Nominum, an early transfer earlier this year from Angel City. So, unfortunately, yeah, not the end result I was expecting, but, you know, Texas does do this early on in the season, so we might see some adjustments later on in the year.
Was a very interesting bout for those of you who have not watched it yet and may be watching it on the archives. I won't spoil it too much, but let's just say Texas did not pull out all the stops as soon as they could do. Gotham, on the other hand, phenomenal first period. Penalty control was marvelous. Scoring was superb. And that seems to have been one of the things for the day so far. Penalties have been king or queen, depending on which bouts you've been watching. First bout of the day, it was Gotham and Philly, the B teams. Quickly recap on the scores. I should have these better controlled. It was Philly 93, Gotham 258. Penalties really played against Philly for that opening bout. Men's roller derby went down the wire. The crowd was electric for Maelstrom versus New York Shock Exchange. Wonderful game. I believe that it's definitely a sign that men's roller derby has matured massively.
Now, I didn't get to watch the second half of the game because I was calling for the Junior Derby, but I did notice the men's game seemed to be a little bit slower, a little tighter pack control, and a lot bigger, harder hits. Is that what you were finding?
The hits were phenomenal. There was a lot of missionary blocking, which went on for some time. The play was simply phenomenal to watch, no two ways about it. Also had juniors today, half-hour bout. Again, phenomenal to watch. Jersey, dominant throughout. Similar penalties both sides, but again, a beautiful thing to watch. Those of you who have not seen Junior Roller Derby yet, I strongly recommend you do need to see it. It is the future of the sport, no two ways. That's what's happened today. Electra, what are your thoughts for what's going to happen tomorrow?
Well, we've seen a couple of firsts for WFTDA TV this tournament so far, and that's the Men's Derby and the Junior Derby. And another exciting first, two teams from Scotland. One from Edinburgh, Ulriki Roller Girls, and then the Glasgow Roller Girls. So they'll be playing games tomorrow and Sunday. And we have a new additional team from Canada, which is Rideau Valley. Montreal, of course, being here since 2009. This is their fifth year. So we had three anthems today. We had the U.S. anthem, we had Canada in two different languages, and the Scottish national anthem. So that's all very exciting.
Do you have any bouts which you are looking forward to specifically tomorrow?
Well, I've been kind of keeping my eye on the Ulriki girls. I've been following their blog a little bit, and I was just in London, actually, last week, talking with Bette Noir, who's very familiar with this team. And so I've been following their blog. They've actually been in town, or actually in New York, for about a week now, and they had a chance to go play the Gotham Traders earlier this week. And that score was very exciting, 170 to 158, with Gotham taking the win. But that's the better showing than we saw with the Philly game earlier today. So very exciting game, I think. I'm excited to watch Ulriki play in any of their games.
Definitely very exciting for the girls from Glasgow and the girls from Edinburgh, Ulriki. It's a long journey. I know that because I made the same journey myself to get over here. I'm very much looking forward to it. This may mean that my accent goes all over the place for the rest of this weekend, as it always does for these kind of bouts. Beyond that, we have, I believe, it is the best part of a dozen bouts tomorrow. We have the best part of a dozen bouts on Sunday also. First whistle local time will be 10:30 a.m. tomorrow morning. If you're watching over in Europe, in the U.K., that's plus 5 hours. Out in Germany and further afield, it's going to be another 2 hours on top of that, so 7 hours ahead of time. Those of you who have got the opportunity over there, please do watch. You're going to enjoy it. Those of you who are watching mainland, continental, North America, you do not want to miss a thing. 10:30 a.m., that will be first whistle. From there on in, it's just going to get better and better.
Now, don't forget, you can also, if you have anything to say to myself or Iltepe or any of our announcers, go to #talk2 WFTDA, or just for information, you can do #ECDX2013. And, of course, you're going to be watching at WFTDA.tv live all weekend.
On behalf of Electra Blue, I'm Al Tupay. Thank you very much for your time. We look forward to you watching again tomorrow. Thank you and good night.